And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2, where we are looking mighty fine in our brand new suits, which was a gift, I guess, from Kasumi Goto, so that we could better look the part of our cover, Mr. Solomon Gunn, mercenary leader, in our mission to help her steal back her deceased lover's gray box, which is apparently some sort of memory storage device. And I'm gonna wear it. which might seem kind of ridiculous, probably because it is kind of ridiculous to wander around the ship in a suit. But you know what? It's a civilian ship, and as I've indicated previously about Gabe here, he does like to dress up. He's not big on military uniforms or uniforms in general, but he doesn't mind putting on a suit and looking fancy. So I'm gonna wear it, because I think it looks pretty damn nice, that's why. Anyway, in the meantime, after we finished helping Kasumi, we went around the system of Beckenstein where we are, and we did a bunch of mining. We were getting pretty low on resources. And resources are always needed. So we mined out what was here, and now I think we're going to leave the galaxy map. My bad.
Commander, Morden requests to see you.
And that is exactly why I wanted to take a quick break before we went into the galaxy map, because I thought Counselor Kelly Chambers might have some valuable information for me, and she did. So let's go have a talk with Dr. Solis. See what he wants to talk about.
Shepard, important news. Know you're busy. Have to deal with the collectors. Planning attack. Too important to wait. Just receiving data. Still processing, analyzing likely scenarios. Not sure how to begin. Too much intel. You remember my work? Studying the genophage?
Yes, I do. But, why don't you give me a refresher on it, Morden?
Refresh my memory.
Studied genophage as part of special tasks group. Checked Krogan population, ensured genophage was working. Didn't tell you full story. Discovered that Krogan population was growing too quickly. Overcoming genophage. Had to take steps. Personally led a team, created new version of genophage, released it onto Chanka, other colonies, re-stabilized Krogan population.
So, wait. You created a different version of the genophage? Dude, when are you guys gonna quit with this controlling of the Krogan population?
The first genophage was a mistake bordering on a war crime.
Yeah.
How the hell could you do it again?
Exactly the reaction feared. In small numbers, Krogan sympathetic. Tragic. Galactic regret for deployment of genophage. But in large numbers, expansion, aggression, war, Krogan too dangerous, had to stop them.
No, man.
Cultural fragmentation made modified genophage even more necessary.
No, you don't have to do anything. Stop trying to control everything. You know that? It's not your place to make those kind of decisions.
We're not done, Morden. You can't just drop a bomb like this and walk away.
Can discuss ethics later. More immediate concerns. Blood Pack mercenaries captured former team member. Malin, last seen on Tuchanka, might torture him, make an example.
Yeah, they might.
Would be a personal favor to me.
Yeah, they might torture him, you know, and I honestly can't say that I'd really feel that bad for him. I mean, the first genophage wasn't enough. You had to go and make it worse.
Do you think they found out your team updated the genophage?
Unclear. No way to determine until we get to T'Chanka.
Oh, Morden, Morden, Morden. You know, I'm tempted to just leave him to his fate, but you know what? That is an example of a person taking an active role in ensuring the fate of one another. That is exactly the type of thing that releasing something like the genophage does as well. So, I'm going to help you. I will help you. He's a friend of yours, and he is a valuable being. So let's take the high road here, and let's do what we can.
We'll go to T'Chanka and see if we can find your team member.
Appreciate it. My assistant, my student, want to see him safe. Malin last seen outside Erdnot territory. Scouts might have seen Blood Pack. Talk to them or Clan Chief.
Erdnot? I might have an in. I have an old friend with the name Erdnot. Erdnot Rex. He might be able to help us. Let's see if we can do any upgrading while we're here. I mean, we're in the tech lab already. Nope, nothing in weapons. Armor. Tech damage. 1000 element zero, do it. Yeah, we don't even need to think about that. I don't even care what the stat boost is, just do it. Ship enhancements, I think, is just going to be the mineral scanner and the medbay upgrade. Basically, both a giant waste of time. Advanced training. What's this? Through intensive training, Shepard can learn to use a single bonus power. Obtaining more loyal squad members will increase the number of powers available for Shepard. Shepard can complete this research project multiple times. Each time the project is completed, Shepard selects a new bonus power, and any points already spent transfer to the newly selected bonus power. Okay, yeah, so I have this now, I think, because of Kasumi's loyalty. So I think the only power that's going to be available is her power, which is Flashbang, I think. Let's not do that just now. We'll check back later on that when there's more powers available. Okay. Should we check with Kelly and make sure there isn't anybody else that wants to talk? Let's do it real quick.
Jack's hey. Tattoos are beautiful. As colorful as her past, I'm sure.
No doubt.
I have concerns with her temper, though.
Concerns with her temper?
You have worries about Jack?
I know she'll be solid under fire. But
yeah.
Her attitude suggests deep personal issues.
Mm-hmm.
She pushes people away, yet approaches sex casually. I don't think she understands her own motivations. I wouldn't be surprised if she makes advances on you. If you want her respect, think twice.
She approaches sex casually, Kelly. I mean, how do you know that? You must have had quite a deep conversation with her, more than I had. But as far as making advances towards me, yeah, you're absolutely right. She already did try and do that a little bit, but don't worry, I'm no dummy.
I'll do my best not to piss her off.
And He's also that.
If you fail, I want a chance to hide. Anyway, how may I help you, Commander?
Just checking in.
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now. Anything else, Commander?
Nope, we're good.
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Yeah, I know. It seems you never move from that spot. Okay. Let's hit a relay and figure out where we want to go next. Also, I'm pretty sure we need to fuel up and...
We have used half our fuel.
Yeah, exactly, Edie. And also, we're probably almost out of probes. Oh, that's not where I want to go. Fuel depot. Buy fuel. Nice. And probes. We were down to less than half, so alright. Sweet. Now, where are we going? Okay, so... Tachanka. That's to help Morden. I don't know if we have any other reason to go there other than that. Otherwise, we could go to Ilium and help Miranda. And also, it looks like we've got some new recruits there. The Justicar and the Assassin. Or we could help Zaid. Those would be the closest things. Let's go to Ilium first, I think. All right. Got a couple of other systems here as well in this cluster. Gonna do the mining later. Let's just go ahead and go straight to Ilium. Oh yes, that's right. Kasumi is loyal now. What's her other look? Oh, I can't really see very well. Is that red? Red and black? Go with it. Whatever. Let's see. Who do we want to take with us? You know, before we build the team, let's help Miranda. Let's get that out of the way. Let's take her and let's take Garrus. That seems good. Alright, I've got 4 points to spend. Nice. Which means we can take one ability. Let's take Incinerate. Garrus, you can take Turian Rebel, which will give you an increase in health, weapon damage, and power damage. And Concussive Shot. Take that. Let's use this level up to just improve abilities. There you go, Miranda. Nice. Okay, and we don't need to change our loadout, so let's go. Oh dear, that doesn't look good.
Welcome to Nos Astra, Commander Shepard. We've been instructed to waive all docking and administration fees for your visit.
Oh.
My name is Karina.
What?
If you need information about the area, it would be my pleasure to assist you.
So we don't gotta pay the docking fees? What's up with that?
Who instructed you to waive the fees?
The order came from Liara Tassoni, who paid all fees on your behalf.
Of course she did.
She also asked that I direct you to speak with her at your convenience. She's near the trading floor.
Yeah, I'm gonna go right now. Are you kidding me? I miss the living hell out of her. But, actually, before we do that, and since I forgot to read the little blurb about Ilium, why don't you tell me about this place?
Do you have any recommendations about what to do on Nos Astra?
Yeah.
Our trading center is directly ahead. You'll find restaurants and shops nearby as well. I suggest you browse our shopping kiosks. You can find things on Nos Astra that you can't find anywhere else in the galaxy.
Okay, we'll do that. Nice.
What can you tell me about Nos Astra?
It's an exciting city. We see a lot of new cultures and goods because of our proximity to the Terminus systems.
Right.
At the same time, Ilium is still in a sorry world. You should be as safe here as you would be on the Citadel. For your own safety, however, I recommend against signing anything.
Yeah, also, trust me, lady, because of my profession, I'm not safe anywhere, so it's a nice sentiment, but I'm more than likely going to get shot at by someone while I'm here, trust me.
What's so dangerous about signing something?
Ilium is a free trade world, Commander. Contract term requirements are more relaxed here than on other planets. It's a small price to pay for keeping our competitive edge in goods from the Terminus systems.
Okay, I mean, that sounds reasonable, but I doubt it's that black and white, as with most things. Why is Liara here? What's that about?
You said Liara was here? What's she doing?
Liara is one of Nos Astra's most respected information brokers.
Nos Astra
is based upon trade. Information is valuable currency, and Liara has done quite well. As I said, you'll find her near the trading floor. She was looking forward to seeing you.
So, Liara's an information broker now? I don't know how I feel about that. She went from xenoarchaeology to information selling? I guess it's not really that different of a thing if you think about it. It's just one thing deals with discovering and, you know, information from ages and species past, whereas the other one deals with current information, I guess.
You mentioned trading. What gets traded on Ilium?
Anything you can imagine, Commander. Ilium is a wonderful world for those who can afford it.
In order
to remain competitive as a
Most of them are,
point,
trust me.
We've relaxed many of the standards you'd find on other Asari worlds. Most drugs are legal, provided they are labeled properly. You can buy almost any weapon or technology. You can even buy indentured servants.
Yeah, see, that's exactly what I was talking about. So you're telling me, again, going back to what you said before, because of the fact that you have such a close proximity to the Terminus systems, you don't outlaw things like slavery? That seems like a layup. I mean, that's just something that we just shouldn't do, you know, as a general rule.
I can't believe an Asari world would allow slavery.
We try to avoid calling it slavery. All indentured
I'm sure you do, yeah.
Have voluntarily agreed to a term of service. Most choose indentured service as a means to pay off debt or avoid imprisonment. A contract holder is responsible for the well-being of her servants, and a servant's duties are agreed upon before the contract is signed.
Right, indentured servitude. I mean, okay, that's fine. I get it's not forced slavery, but still, that's a little bit close to all-out slavery for my mind, anyway. Looking for someone? Yeah, let's see if maybe we can get some information on our recruits.
I'm on a mission. Can you help me find someone?
I can help you find major entertainment centers or stores, but I'm afraid I can't point you to individual people.
Right.
Liara is excellent at that type of work, however.
Yeah, I bet
she is.
I imagine
she can help you.
Yeah, being an information broker, she probably knows quite a lot. All right, well, thanks. Thanks for all the info.
Thank you.
Again, welcome to our city, Commander. Please enjoy your stay.
I'm gonna try.
Customs records indicated just a car named Samara is visiting this port, Shepard. Your former teammate, Liara Tassoni, may have more information. Her office overlooks the trading floor.
Okay,
you
yeah.
You wish to speak with her regarding the whereabouts of Thane Krios, the assassin on your dossier, as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Also, I have a message for Miss Lawson. Lantea has reserved a room at Eternity and will be waiting.
Thank you, Edie.
Yeah, no. Miranda... I... I'm sorry.
Employees only to lose them to your competitors. Perhaps
your,
help, the leading provider of cutting edge,
you know, your sister and all that is really super important to me. It absolutely is. But I hope you won't take too much offense.
I lost it somewhere.
25.
If I
excuse me, are you Commander Shepard?
Yes, I am.
You're Commander Shepard. I saw your. I guess you would say your aura.
Huh?
I'd recognize you anywhere.
Okay.
I was asked to give you a message if I saw you. It's from a friend you made on Novaria.
A friend I made on Novaria. I don't really recall making a lot of friends on Novaria. In fact, I don't make very many friends wherever I go. I usually end up shooting a lot of people, but, go ahead, I guess.
I met a lot of people on Novaria. Could you be more specific?
Yeah.
I believe the message itself should make it clear.
Okay.
Shepard.
Whoa.
We
what
hide.
The?
We borrow. We build. But we know that you seek those who soured the songs of our mothers.
Oh.
When the time comes, our voice will join with yours.
The
Rachni. Our crescendo. We'll burn the darkness clean. Thank you, Shepard. The Rachni will sing again because of you.
Okay, the Rachni Queen. Yeah, I guess that would be a friend I made on Novaria. I did spare her life. Oh, God. Well, I mean, I gotta admit, that message didn't sound, you know, evil or bad or anything.
I'm glad to hear that you're rebuilding. Are you somewhere close by?
The Rachni Queen is not here. That message is one of many memories I carry from her. I encountered her on an uncharted world. She saved my life.
She saved
more than that. She gave me a purpose. They are an amazing people, Shepard. The galaxy owes you a great debt for giving them a second chance.
Well, I gotta admit, it's good to hear that they're not... that they're doing good. I mean, maybe you could be right.
How did you find the Rachni?
I was working as a courier. Pirates ambushed my ship, and I was forced down on an uncharted planet. I was badly injured, alone and near death. Then they found me. They saved me.
Yeah, this is actually a pertinent question. What happened to the pirates?
What happened to the pirates who attacked you?
They were obliterated.
Okay.
As they should have been.
Well,
the Rachni are not aggressive, but they do what they must.
Yeah, I mean, it was probably the right thing to do, but
you obviously got off world again. Did the Rachni give you a ship?
No. Countless workers repaired my ship. It runs better now than it did before.
Really?
They remind me of the keepers on the Citadel in a way.
Yeah.
All working together, each with a purpose.
Yeah, speaking of purpose, you mentioned that before. You mentioned you now have a purpose. What did you mean?
You said the Queen gave you a purpose. What do you mean?
The Queen shared her song with me as I recovered. I saw the Rachni as only an Asari could. They are so beautiful and so vulnerable. They needed someone to purchase things they cannot make themselves. Someone to work within the system. An agent, if you will. I am happy to help. My life as a courier was empty and shallow. Now I'm helping a great race rebuild itself.
And it kind of falls into your expertise, really. I mean, you're basically a courier now, a liaison, basically. They need things, you get them, you courier them back. So, Sounds like a good arrangement, actually.
You were really comfortable walking away from your old life?
You're concerned that the Queen is controlling me.
A little, yeah.
I understand, but it doesn't work like that. Our minds were in perfect harmony. I saw their beautiful spirit and their need. I knew what I had to do. If some part of that is suggestion, then it was a side effect from their efforts to save my life. I am happy.
Well, okay. I guess that means... I mean, that means something. If you're happy, you're happy. That's... It's not a bad thing.
Can you tell me where the Rachni are?
I'm afraid not. I don't even have that information myself any longer.
Okay.
After I met the Rachni Queen, that information was removed. It's not painful, but I simply don't remember. I'll remember when I need to. And her caution is understandable.
Yeah.
The galaxy isn't yet ready for the return of the Rachni.
No, that's true. Tell her to be good. Well, I think she knows that. I don't think we need to reiterate our feelings about how we want the Rachni to proceed.
Thank you for giving me that information. I'm glad my friend Anavaria is doing well.
Be well, Commander Shepard. You will not see me again.
Well, I can honestly say that I had my suspicions that that decision back on Novaria so long ago now, I had my suspicions that that would come to haunt me, for lack of a better word, in the future, but as of right now, I really couldn't have imagined a better outcome. But anyway, on
Holy
to see...
Crap, Shepard? I thought you were dead.
Oh my god. Gianna Parasini, also from Novaria. You gotta be shitting me.
Shepard, the news said you were dead. What happened? No, wait, probably classified.
Yeah.
I asked. You just have to lie.
Yep.
It's been a couple of years. I'm Gianna Parasini, Novaria Internal Affairs.
Yeah.
You helped me nail Administrator Analeas.
Hell yeah, I did. Also, if I'm not mistaken, I think you said next time I see you, you had to buy me a drink. So, pony up, girl. Let's go.
Happy to help. What happened to Administrator Analeas?
He made the one mistake Novaria won't tolerate. He got caught taking their money.
Yeah.
He's doing a few years in white-collar prison. More importantly, he won't work in the field again. Sit down. If I remember right, I owe you a beer.
Yep, you sure do.
What brings you to Ilium? You know, that you can talk about.
Yeah, I'm on a mission. You know I can't tell you, Gianna. I shouldn't tell anybody, really. I should probably not even be talking to you, but I can't resist catching up with an old friend.
I'm working on a top-secret project. Mostly putting together a team and doing research right now.
Yeah.
Sounds vague.
It is.
No offense taken. I've been undercover enough to know how it goes.
Yeah. What's going on?
Hey, listen, I just remembered something. I've got to go. Talk to you later. And don't forget to drink your beer.
Wait, what? Oh, I get it. You're undercover right now, aren't you? Oh, Gianna. Shepard. Had to leave. Target saw me. Couldn't break cover. Asari merchant smuggling schematics from Novaria. Can you talk her into showing you the good stuff? Oh, Gianna. Getting me involved in crazy... frickin' espionage all over again.
I'm looking for
Gotta be honest, though. Can't resist.
Welcome.
Hey!
You look like someone who needs high-quality equipment.
Hell yeah.
Feel free to look around. My store has the best tech and biotic equipment on Ilium.
Is everything here so expensive? I'd plan to drop a lot of credits today.
It's true.
Really?
I'm outfitting a team for a dangerous mission. I need the best and I'm willing to pay for it. As long as you work with me.
Well, perhaps I could give you a preferred rate at the kiosk.
Thanks.
Here, a small discount, and when I get special items in, you can take a look.
Special items? Like what?
What kind of special items are we talking about?
Oh, you know, schematics, designs. Nothing illegal, but I may not have all the licenses to sell them.
Like I said, though, I'm putting together a serious team for a dangerous mission, so come on, man. Come on, what do you really got? What's behind the counter, as they say?
Do you have anything else? Anything not listed on your main merchandise kiosk?
Well, there is one thing. Very advanced design. Not publicly available yet.
Let's hear it.
That's because it's still in development on Novaria, and illegal for export. Hello, Hermia.
Parasini, you set me up!
Yeah,
this
she did.
This isn't Novaria. You don't have the authority to arrest me.
I don't care whether you go to jail. I've got all the evidence I need to find you out of business.
What about the schematic? I'm not gonna... That doesn't... Asking about that make me just as illegal as her? Let's just close it out, I guess.
Is that everything you needed?
Everything and more. You're a lifesaver, Shepard.
I know.
I need to
I'm
go.
I'm the best.
I have to talk to my lawyer.
Yeah, you probably should.
Talk fast, Hermia. When the fines hit, you won't be able to afford him.
Dang.
Ah, that was good. I've got to go file a few papers. Come by my table when you've got a minute.
So, Gianna, what in the hell was that all about?
Hermia is going to be a very poor woman very shortly. Thanks for the help, Shepard.
You're welcome.
I love nailing Asari. So ageless and superior. Then you get them and they squeal like schoolgirls.
Yeah, I bet that can be pretty entertaining.
It must be nice having a job that you really enjoy.
I wanted to be a cop or CSEC, but my family had bills. I needed the money a corporate job brought in. Besides, in this job, you don't see things that make it hard to sleep at night.
Yeah.
White-collar crime is nice and clean.
That's true.
At least this time, I didn't have to wear heels and a dress.
Oh, come on, Gianna. Now, you know, from one spy to another, I gotta tell you, you were rocking those heels and that dress. Just saying.
It must be hard, going undercover so often.
It's not so bad. Go new places, be new people. The only weird part is when you go home and try to talk to people, and you forget how to react. Like it's another cover, you know?
Yeah, no, I know exactly what you mean.
Deep down, part of you likes fooling people. That's what makes you good at it.
Part of me, yeah. I grew up poor and working class. Now I walk around the rich and powerful, taking notes, getting evidence. And they never see me coming.
You're almost making it sound so much fun that I'm thinking about exploring it as a new career option myself. Stop doing that.
How'd you end up on Novaria, anyway?
Scholarship program and a competitive internship. Turned out I was only middling at the science, but I could always ferret out secrets. You grow up poor and surrounded by rich kids, you get good at hiding yourself. Helps with going undercover.
Yeah, right, I suppose. That's true. You were spent your whole... life undercover, being poor, trying to play it up as a rich person.
What's up next for you?
Research. We've had some hacking attacks lately, and I want to make sure they're external. A lot of people are suddenly interested in dark energy. My bosses want to know if it's something to worry about. That'll hold me over until I have to go back undercover anyway.
Interest in dark energy? In what way? Is like some sort of business opportunity, or... That sounds weird, but I suppose it's probably a good thing you're looking into it. Anyway, frickin' awesome to see you again, and thanks for that little undercover business. That was kind of fun, I gotta admit. And thank you for the beer.
It's been a pleasure, Gianna.
You too, Shepard. See you around.
Bye-bye.
Hell with it.
Mwah. Whoa, okay.
Much better than an autograph. Take care of yourself, Shepard.
Okay, you too, thanks. Jeez. What can I say, guys? I'm, you know, popular guy, you know? People like me. Garrus,
another difficult
don't give me that look, man.
Expansion as the colony on Horizon has been attacked. The council
Nick Saris!
Hello, Commander Shepard.
Oh, you know me. Okay.
You're Liara's assistant?
Yes. Liara relies upon me to acquire useful intelligence. I don't have her network of contacts, but I supply her with supplemental data. It's really an honor to work with her.
Yeah, okay. I guess.
What's Liara's reputation here on Ilium?
She is greatly respected. In a few short years, she's amassed a sizable network of connections. She could have even more political power than she already wields if she weren't so focused on her personal goals. But I believe she should tell you about that, not me.
What are her personal goals, then? Well, I guess you just said I should ask her about it, and you're probably right.
I'll talk to you later.
Of course, Commander.
All right. Liara, oh, God. I really wish I could ask you guys to just wait outside, because... Well, because reasons. Garrus, stop it.
Have you faced an Asari commando unit before? Few humans have. I'll make it simple. Either you pay me, or I flay you alive. With my mind.
Oh
Shepard,
my God. I just fell in love with you all over again.
My sources said you were alive, but I never believed. It's very good to see you.
Oh, Liara? The reason that there's probably very few words on this wheel of things to say is because... there are no words to describe how happy I am to see you again, truly.
It's good to see you too, Liara. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. I've been working as an information broker.
I've
it's
heard.
Paid the bills since you... Well, for the past 2 years.
Yeah.
And now you're back, gunning for the collectors with Cerberus.
Come with me. Come on, Shep. She's not gonna come with you. She clearly has her own thing going here. I wish she would come with me so deeply, but we know it's not gonna happen, so let's not go there. Let's just be surprised about how well-informed she is, you know, because she's only an information broker.
That's not exactly public knowledge.
Neither is you being alive, Shepard. Information is my business now.
That's
and
true.
And if you need information on finding people, I'm happy to help.
Hey, that's good. Yeah, I kind of do. Let's see if she's got any information on Thane Krios, the assassin.
I'm looking for Thane Krios. He's supposed to be here on Ilium.
The assassin? Yes. He arrived here a few days ago. My sources tell me he may be targeting a corporate executive, Nisana Dantius.
I know her.
He contacted a woman named Serena. Serena has an office in the cargo transfer levels. Perhaps she can tell you where Krios is.
Nisana Dantius, I know her. Remember, we helped her... We unwittingly helped her eliminate... her sister, which was her direct competition in her sort of pseudo-crime ring that she was wanting to run.
That was all just off the top of your head?
I'm a very good information broker, Shepard.
I bet you are. You're good at everything you do, girl.
The world isn't different from a dig site, except that the dead bodies still smell.
Yeah, that's true. And what about this Justicar?
There's an Asari named Samara here on Ilium. Do you know where I could find her?
Samara. Yes. She arrived recently and registered with Tracking Officer Dara. You can find Dara at the transportation hub.
Tracking Officer? What's that about?
Why would Samara have to register with a Tracking Officer? Is she a criminal?
No. In fact, she's quite the opposite. Samara is a Justicar,
yeah.
One of an ancient sect of Asari warriors. Dara can tell you more.
Okay, good. Yeah, because... That... That wasn't a whole lot of information. This is all we got. We've sat down at a desk with our once and true love, and this is what we got, huh? Okay, all right.
Thanks for the help. That's all I needed to know.
Of course. If there's anything else I can help you with, let me know.
Let's get the Shadow Broker. No. We're not going to do that right now. Let's see if she'll come with us. We got to try. I mean, I think I know what her answer's going to be, but we should give it a try.
What about you, Liara? I could use your help on this mission.
Yeah, come on.
I can't, Shepard.
Come on.
I'm sorry. I have commitments here. Things I need to take care of.
Like what?
What kind of things do you need to take care of? Are you in trouble?
No trouble. But it's been a long 2 years. I had things to do while you were gone. I have debts to repay. Listen, if you want to help, I need someone with hacking expertise. Someone I can trust.
Hey, that's me. I'm your man.
If you could disable security at key points around Ilium,
yeah,
you could get me information I need. That would help me a great deal.
I'll do it, absolutely. Yeah. Just tell me what's going on. I mean, I'm gonna do it, but if you've got trouble, tell me. I'll help you.
What's this all about, Liara? Can't you just talk to me?
Don't you think I want to, Shepard? This isn't because I don't trust you. This is Ilium. Anything I say is probably being recorded.
Yeah, I guess that's fair. You're right, and I'm sorry. I should have known that if you're being tight-lipped, it's because you have to be. But yeah, give me the information. I'll hack whatever I'll hack every computer on this planet.
If it'll help you, I'll take care of it.
When you hack one, a server will open somewhere nearby for a short time. You can download data from there, if you hurry. Thank you, Shepard. This may help me pay a great debt.
Anytime.
I'll talk to you later, Liara.
For sure. For sure we'll talk later. No doubt. And also, I love you. I... Didn't really have the opportunity to say that, but I do.
Does living at a higher altitude make you more intelligent? Our report may
so, I think, if I'm not mistaken,
I need minimal heat increase.
Miranda's contact
and speed.
Is in the club here, Eternity, so let's make a quick stop in there and meet with her contact, and then
I'm gonna
we'll
have
go
that asshole
there.
Arrested.
Find Troublemaker. Go to Eternity and apparently find a Troublemaker. Well, I guess we should probably do that as well. Oh, let me guess. That's the Troublemaker. I can't believe it. Flippin' Conrad Werner.
You're really
holding
out
God.
On me? I'm a man on the edge. I got nothing to lose.
Uh-huh.
I'll do anything to get the job done. I'll go all the way without a second thought.
Uh-huh.
Conrad.
You want to see how far I'll go? I learned how to shove a gun in people's faces from... Commander Shepard?
Hey, if you know this idiot, can you rein him in before I slap his ass with a singularity?
Yeah, I got it. Don't hurt him. He's
me.
He's
Conrad Werner.
Misguided.
We met on the Citadel. I wanted to become a Spectre.
Yeah.
Oh, and then you shoved a gun in my face. You
Did
showed
I?
Me what it meant to be truly extreme. I learned that lesson well. So you're alive, huh? I hear it goes like that in the biz.
Oh, God.
Why don't you sit back and watch how it's done? I got some asses to kick.
Conrad. Oh. Just... No. Go home.
Conrad, why are you acting like me?
What, are you crazy? I'm nothing like you. I'm not a specter working for the Council. I'm on my own, backed only by my wits and my nerves. No rules, no laws, just whatever it takes to get the job done.
Oh, God.
I'm not like you at all.
Yeah, okay, so... So, what? Where'd you get your training then, Conrad?
Conrad, do you have any actual combat training?
I'm saving the galaxy, Shepard. I don't have time for training.
Oh,
don't
Jesus.
You get it? You were a big jerk.
Yeah, I get it. You're an idiot.
And showed other races that humans mattered. And then you died. The galaxy needed someone like you, Shepard. We all did. I had to do something.
And Conrad, what's with the armor, dude? Come on.
How did you get that armor?
Oh, they make some pretty convincing replicas these days, if you're willing to pay. Getting the whole getup was pretty expensive, but my wife was really supportive.
Yeah.
She even paid for my shuttle fare off-world.
Wow. Yeah, maybe she was a little too supportive, Conrad. In fact, I think you might have too much support in your life altogether. It's probably why I shoved that gun in your face, which I don't actually remember doing, but you might be right. You know, it's 2 years and, you know, I died and then came back to life. You're bound to lose a few memories, I would think. What's this? I'm afraid to ask this, but what's this job you're on?
So you just wander the galaxy righting wrongs?
Hey, don't say it like that. I talk to people, you know? Ask them if they have big problems that only I can solve.
Yeah,
you'd be surprised
okay.
How many people are just waiting for someone to talk to them.
No, I wouldn't.
Sometimes I poke through crates, too. You know, for extra credits.
Oh, yeah, really? I've never done that. I don't know what you're talking about at all.
Any decent security system will detect that you aren't in the military, much less part of my squad.
Yeah.
I just say that I'm deep cover and don't appear on systems.
Oh, God.
I'm doing the best I can, okay? You were a hero. You saved the galaxy and showed everyone what humanity could do.
Oh, we...
And then you died.
Yeah, you told me about that.
The galaxy needed someone like you, Shepard. We all did. I had to do something.
So, what are you doing here, then, on Ilium, that other than acting like an absolute ass?
Why were you trying to get the deed to this place?
This place is actually a front for a red sand dealer. I need to take it over to crack the ring.
What?
Who the hell told you that?
Yeah.
The owner of that weapons store near the carport? She's an undercover cop.
No, she
isn't. She told
me
about it when I introduced myself.
Yeah, no.
Listen, crap for brains. First, we don't sell red sand. Second, red sand is legal on Ilium. You just need a license.
Yeah, also that, dude. Drugs are legal here. It's not... Oh, God. What have you got yourself into? Tell you what, Conrad, okay? You've done enough. You've got all this evidence. You did great work here. Let me take it from here. You just relax, man.
I'll talk to this undercover cop and figure out what's going on.
Yep.
Thank you. If I kill annoying customers, it usually causes property damage. That comes out of my pay.
Just let me know if you need any help, Shepard.
I guess... This day is just filled with things coming back to haunt me from the past. Could it get any worse?